In this video, we'll show you many different ways that you can use the H9000 with a Universal Audio Apollo or similar audio interface. They are as follows. Using the H9000 as an aggregate device for Mac, in which you can combine the I/O of your existing audio interface with those of the H9000 to create one expansive interface with H9000 algorithm processing. Using the H9000 as an ADAT expander to increase the inputs of your Apollo without H9000 processing. Using the H9000 as an ADAT expander to increase the Apollo inputs while also being able to process the incoming audio through the H9000's effect algorithms with very low latency. Using console to mix and monitor the Apollo's inputs with low latency H9000 processing. In this example, we are not expanding the existing audio interface's input count. We are using the Apollo console to send and return any of the Apollo's inputs to any of the H9000's effect chains. Using console to mix and monitor with H9000 effects after recording. In this example, you'll be using the Apollo to record, but then switching to the H9000 for producing, processing, and mixing. Finally, we'll talk about saving your settings in a session so that you can instantly recall any of these uses. First off, if you're looking to use the H9000 as a 16-channel USB audio interface, watch our H9000 I/O tutorial. In that video, we cover setup for both Mac and Windows. And for Mac users, we explain how to create an aggregate device in which you can combine the H9000's USB or expansion interfaces with your existing audio interface to create one expansive audio interface. As you can see in this example here, I have 16 channels of H9000 USB audio, and beginning with channel 17 is my Universal Audio Apollo I/O. I have the Dante card installed, so if I wanted to, I could also include my 32 channels of Dante I/O in my aggregate device. For detailed setup on creating an aggregate device, watch our I/O tutorial. The Apollo has 8 analog inputs, but this input count can be expanded by using the ADAT protocol, which is the transfer of up to 8 channels of digital audio at the sample rates of 44.1 or 48 kHz. To utilize this method, plug your gear into any of the H9000's inputs. Then connect an optical cable from the optical output of your H9000 to the optical input of the Apollo. Next, connect an optical cable from the optical output of the Apollo to the optical input of the H9000. To use any of the H9000's digital protocols, the external digital signal and the H9000 must be locked to the same digital clock at the same sample rate. In this example, we'll be using the Apollo as the clock source and syncing the H9000's clock via the ADAT connection we've already set up. Alternatively, you can sync your equipment using another method, such as word clock using the BNC connectors or another digital protocol. Remember that if your Apollo is the clock source, you'll have to set the Apollo's internal clock to a supported sample rate when using ADAT. In Emote, set both the clock source and digital audio mode to ADAT. This will effectively use the Apollo as the master clock. From here, there are two different ways of using the H9000. The first method is for tracking purposes without any effects processing. We'll set up the first example as if we are using the H9000's analog inputs 1 through 8. On the direct I/O page of Emote, connect the H9000's 8 analog inputs to ADAT channels 1 through 8. Now any signal fed into the H9000's analog inputs will be directly routed to the H9000's ADAT output, physically connected to the Apollo. These can be monitored in console or recorded in your DAW using channels 9 through 16 of the Apollo. We'll now save this setup as a session to instantly recall the next time we want to double the Apollo's input count without using the H9000's onboard effects. Note that sessions also save the network settings which need to match in order to get Emote to work properly. The second session will be for setting up the H9000 with effects processing. For this session, we are going to remove the direct output connections. Now set up your effects chains to include your desired algorithms. On the effects chain screen, choose the inputs you are currently using to feed through the effects chain. If your gear is plugged into the analog inputs of the H9000, choose the appropriate analog inputs. In my example, my gear is plugged into an 8-channel preamp, and those 8 channels are being fed via the ADAT protocol into my H9000's optical input. In this example, all 3 devices are clocked by an Apogee Big Ben and an emote we've chosen Word Clock as the clock source. The digital audio mode remains ADAT. Now I'll proceed to route my gear through some H9000 effects chains. Being that my signals are coming from my H9000's ADAT outputs, on the effects chain page of emote, I will choose ADAT channels 1 and 2 for my first effects chain. And I will choose the corresponding ADAT outputs for each chain to feed the Apollo. Now I'll set up ADAT channels 3 and 4 for my second effects chain, and ADAT channels 5 and 6 for my third effects chain. Now my Apollo's onboard analog inputs 1 through 8 are routed directly through console, while channels 9 through 16 of the Apollo are receiving the audio coming from the H9000. These channels 9 through 16 can be routed through any of my effects chains, which allows me to process my gear with the H9000 at the input before reaching Apollo's console. Now for another cool way to incorporate the H9000 with the Apollo by using the ADAT protocol and the optical I/O of both units. In this method, you'll be able to use the Apollo as your main audio interface, but also have your H9000 to mix and process incoming audio. First, connect the optical out from the Apollo to the H9000's optical in. Connect the optical out from the H9000 to the Apollo's optical in. For this scenario, we'll use the Apollo as the master clock. In the emote's clock setting, select ADAT for both clock source and digital audio mode. Create an effects chain using ADAT 1 and 2 for the inputs and outputs, and make appropriate connections for audio to pass through any desired algorithms. From here, there are 2 different ways to set up things in console. The first way is a bit more simple, so we'll start there. In the console app, start by stereo linking your input as well as ADAT 1 and 2. To do this, control-click on the text below each track and select Link. On the Output tab above your stereo input, set your output to ADAT 1 and 2. Note that if Mirror to Monitor is selected, you will hear the unaffected signal of your Apollo's input channel. For this example, we will uncheck it so that we only hear the H9000 affected signal. Our stereo analog input will now be sent to H9000 ADAT 1 and 2, processed through the effects chain we set up before, and returned to ADAT 1 and 2 in console. This is a great way to process with Eventide effects with very low latency, the same way you're able to process with console's UA plugins, or to monitor with Eventide effects before you commit them on your recording. Now you can mix and process this further in console and set up multiple channels following the same process. The first setup works pretty well, but there is no way to control how much of the signal you are sending to the H9000's effects chain. This second setup will allow you to control the amount of signal. Set the output tabs above the analog channels back to monitor. Click on the Cue output setting on the right-hand side of console. You might have to change the settings in console to make this appear. Set Q1 source to Q1, not mix. Set Q1 mirror to output setting to ADAT 1 and 2. If ADAT is not an option here, that means you have something else routed to ADAT 1 and 2 in console, and you'll have to change that setting. On analog 1 and 2, or any channel you're using, under the Sends tab, C1 will now be your send fader for ADAT output 1 and 2. Using Q1, you can now send any channel to the effects chain with ADAT I/O 1 and 2, and it will be returned to console on ADAT channel 1 and 2. The next way we will discuss using the H9000 alongside your Apollo is by using the Apollo to record and track your instruments, and then to switch your audio interface to the H9000 for producing, processing, and mixing. Note that anytime you change the H9000 sample rate, you'll have to go through the procedure outlined in our I/O tutorial, or you may encounter a sample rate mismatch warning, resulting in the muting of all USB audio. To try this method, record your tracks as you normally would using your existing audio interface. Once your tracks have been recorded, switch the audio interface in your DAW's preferences to the H9000's USB interface. You'll now have 16 channels of I/O to and from your DAW for processing. However, as discussed in the I/O tutorial, the H9000 does not have monitoring capabilities, and we need a way to hear the H9000 since our studio monitors are currently connected to the Apollo. We are going to keep our monitors plugged into the Apollo, but we will use two of the Apollo's inputs to feed the main stereo analog output of the H9000. In this example, my H9000 is plugged directly into analog inputs 5 and 6 of the Apollo. Inside of Emote, on the direct routing page, connect USB outputs 1 and 2 to analog outputs 1 and 2. Now within my DAW, my master outputs, USB 1 and 2, are being fed from the H9000's main outputs to the Apollo's physical inputs 5 and 6. I can now control the H9000's output by adjusting the input fader of channels 5 and 6 in Apollo's console. My other USB I/O are available for processing through the H9000's effects chains. In this example, using Ableton's external audio effect plugin, I can route the audio from this track to the H9000's USB inputs 3 and 4, and have the affected signal return from the H9000's USB outputs 3 and 4. In Emote, I have set up an effects chain from USB 3 and 4 through my desired algorithms, and then out to USB channels 3 and 4. Now that we have this configured, once again we'll save the session so we can easily recall this setup. A session will save all your current system settings, including your network settings, clock source, I/O configuration, FX chains, and direct I/O connections. In the menu bar of Emote, choosing Save As will allow you to save your session to your local hard drive. Alternatively, go to Session, Save to H9000 to save the session to the H9000 itself. Note that once you've saved a session to the H9000, it will show up in the browser section of Emote under the Sessions tab. We can now simply load this session to recall the configuration we've just set up. This makes it simple to load up one of our previously mentioned uses to record, and then load up another session with some of our favorite effects chains to process the recording after. These are just a few of the ways to use an Eventide H9000 in your existing audio setup. If you have a unique way that you use the H9000, please let us know in the comments below. On behalf of Eventide Audio, thanks for watching.